Yeah, so hello everyone, and we are back with another video, and this time I am here in front of you. So we are dealing with today gas station problem. It's not the human gas, okay? So let's just dig into the problem. There are around n gas stations along a circular route where the amount of gas at station I is gas I. I mean gas at particular index I, and the car has unlimited capacity, or the cost of gas is like I from traveled here to there, and this is what we are getting. And if you see the first input, only to note about this is if you get a circular circuit, you give him the starting point. If you have not got anything, you can return minus one. So we have to note following thing. If there exists a solution, it is guaranteed to be unique. Both input arrays are non-empty and have the same length. Each element in the input array is a non-negative integer. Okay. So this is a solution for us. I hope you have seen this and then you have come to this particular video. Or not, we can explain you a bit that it is given at index 3. We will fill up with 4 gas and we will travel to 5, and we can consume only one cost, right? We will be having 3 with us here. So then we'll reach here at 5. We will have 5 plus 3 left over. That is called 8. Same thing, we will come here. We will invest 2. So sorry for this thing. We will invest 2, and then we will be having 6 here. Then we will be adding this one gas we are getting from the index 0. We'll have 7. We'll invest 3. We will have 4. 4 plus 2, we will have 6. We'll invest 2 again. 4 again, we will have 2. 2 plus 3, 5. 5 minus 5 will be 0. So we will be having exact petrol. Okay, so I have made a small animation for you guys so that we can easily understand this. And let's hope you find it useful. So this is our car. There are our petrol pumps, and this is our cash flow. Okay, so if you see the first one, I'm using this pen. So if you see the first one, the car is here, and you know here the input is minus 2, so the car won't go anywhere else. It will just be where it is. Second, the car is at second or first index, maybe you can say. Okay, so here also it's minus 2, and car won't move anywhere. Coming to third, we will have again minus 2. Car won't move anywhere else. When we go to the fourth petrol pump, that means the third index, here we will have a positive variance, right? Difference basically. So here we'll come here, it will be becoming 8. We will have 8 liters of gas. We will invest 2 here. Okay, we come here now. We will have 7 gas. We will invest 3 here. We will have 4 remaining. So you can travel further. Here we will have 6. We'll invest 4. So we will have 2 remaining. We can travel further. And same thing, we will have it here 5. And we can invest all of them. We will have 0 remaining. But yeah, we can travel because here we will be away again, be having 4. So this is how the car will travel. If you see, it will come here, it will go and like this. I'm just saying, following a circuit for you guys, and we will leave our car to its original destination wherever it wants to go. And yeah, so this was a small animation for you guys. I hope you liked it. And yeah, let's just dig into the problem right now. So as I told you here, if you see that if you start from 2, it will automatically be the cost will be greater. Same thing here. But if you go with 4, the cost will be 1. You will come here 1, 2 plus 1, 3. 3 plus 3, 0. So it's okay. But again, if you come here, you will have a negative 1. So output you will save as 1 because you cannot follow a circular loop. So the first solution I performed was basically simple one. I just made this as a replica. I mean, see, if you see, I put a travel length, total dry, current petrol, start index, and I am starting from 0 to gas dot length. So current petrol will be 0. And I know better approach is coming, but I'm saying that what was the first approach I did. Okay, so start will be from the starting of the index, and I am adding the petrol, what how much petrol we have, and then the cycle is 0. I want to do a full cycle, and then only I'll say okay, we are good. So here we are putting the how much the length is, like obviously we should go to till the whole circular route, right? So it should be the array length. So till the time we have length greater than 0, we will go inside the loop, and then we will be decreasing the current petrol with the cost we are getting in the particular index. If the cost current petrol reaches greater less than 0, we will break it out and we will directly move to the next index or next petrol pump, and we'll start from the next petrol pump. Otherwise, we will increment the start. I mean, if 0, you will increment it to 1. We will decrement because 1 length we have traveled 1, yeah. Okay. And if the start is greater than gas dot length minus 1, because we are starting from the fourth, third index, and if we reach fourth, so we have to start from 0 because we have to complete the circle. So that I'll do here. And then current petrol again I'm adding there, and it will again go to that loop. And I'm incrementing the cycle. That means we will be going till like if we have completed one whole cycle, that means it has reached that particular circular orbit and we can come out. And once we come out, we see if the cycle is equals to gas dot length, we return 1. Okay, otherwise not 1 actually in the index. So otherwise we again go inside this for loop and we reach till last, and if nothing comes out, we will return as minus 1. So coming to this, we are getting the solution DP. Okay. So now this is the one which is kind of a dynamic problem, because I was telling you about the circular array, right? So it comes about the maximum subarray problem, something like that. So there we just have to maintain here a start and end index. I have done some kind of thing for you here. So see, this is what my solution looks like, and this is what the first iteration looks like. So I won't be explaining this, but I'll be explaining this in a bit, like a simple small thing, and what you can follow if you are a beginner. If you are expert, I don't think so you're going for this video. If you are a beginner, you can do this kind of simulation. Whatever variables you will have, you will put on down the variables, you will put down the incremental loop, and you will see what particular code is doing in this variable. So if you see it here, we are basically moving along. We are putting our variables and we are moving around the loop. And first we are getting the difference, what the difference is, and then we are also getting the sum of the difference. For sum, we are getting the max location where we can start, where we can have. And if the max location is less than 0, we will not put the new start. I mean, the actual start we will not put. If you see, we are not putting actual start. We are just going forward, and we are also maintaining a minimum location, like where the minimum thing can be done. If you see this, right? So that I mean, in this case, we will be going with this end minimum. So, and then minimum location will be max dot min, and all those things will be there, and then returning minus 1, and sum will be there. So just to explain you the first whole thing, I'll explain. Like suppose for first count, right, in incremental 0, we will have a difference as minus 2. We will have sum as minus 2 also, because sum will be 0 plus minus 2. Then we will have the max location as 0, because it's 0. And if you see the max location plus difference, that means minus 2, less than 0, yes, the max location will be 0. The new start max will be minus 1. Okay, because we are putting, and then it will not go here, it will not go here, and it will go into a minimum location where we will be just doing the same thing, max location plus difference, minimum location plus difference. But here we are getting the max, here we will be giving the minimum. So minimum will be minus 1. Okay, And then because min also will take, and if min is less, is greater than minimum location, starting min will be zero. It will be greater than minimum location. So we will put the minimum location in min, and we will put the n minimum as the index. Going to one, we will have difference minus two. Sum will be minus two plus minus two, minus four. Max location will not be there. Max will not be there. Minimum location will be there because minimum location plus basically this minus four will be there. Okay. And then we will be having, because this one is greater than this, right? So we will be having this particular minus four here, and min will be the first I because of this. If minimum is, min is greater than minimum location, min is equal to minimum location and is equal to I. Going to the second one, again, nothing goes up, sum incremented, max location zero, this will be zero, minimum location will be zero, minimum will be six, and min will be two. So here, now we comes on the third array where we get a difference as a positive value. We decrement, we basically we sum, and minus six plus three is equal to minus three. And here we see that new start, because max difference plus max location is zero plus difference is three is greater than zero. So it will not go here. It will go to the else loop. It will say if new start max is equal to minus one. Yeah, it is minus one. That means till now there has been no fresh start. Okay, nothing has been done which was going forward. So, or I mean, it was done before, but now because after that something happens and then that petrol cannot go start. So it will be starting from the next index. So the new start max will be the current index as of now, and max location will be plus difference. Same thing here. Okay, so it will be zero plus three. It will be three. Now it will be doing the max is less than max location. Yeah, zero is less than three. So we will put it here. Now we'll put the starting max. So the maximum point we can start from is three. We can put it here. And n minimum will be three because now minimum location will be minus three because minimum location is minus six plus three, same thing. And minimum will be minus three also. So the start max is three and minimum is also will be three and new start max will be three. Now we go to fourth index, the last one. Here the difference will be three. So how three? It is five minus two, three. Now our sum will be zero because minus three plus three is zero. Same thing. Our maximum location will be six because if you see, this one will not come, this one will not go. We will see max is less than max location. Yeah. So this is where there is a bit of jumbled up. If you see the, what you can see, the max location plus difference, right? The max location plus difference. Okay, there was a bit of jumbled up. Yeah, so it will not go inside this loop because max is not greater than max location. It's equal to them. So the max location will be three. The max will be three as of now. We already reached the end. So okay, let it be like this. Sorry for this. And it will come up here minimum. So if you see again, it will say minimum location plus difference. Okay. So minimum location plus difference. What was the minimum location before? It was minus three. Difference was three. It will go to zero. And min is greater than minimum location. No. So minimum will be minus three only. And this will not go inside this time. And the start max will be three. And n min will be three. So now what happens is we see if the sum is less than zero. No. Sum is exact zero. So it will not return minus one. If the sum minus min greater than max, sum is zero, minus min is minus three. So no, it's not greater than max. It will not return this. It is because if suppose the straightforward loop is not seen, you have seen first two something somewhere and then later it broke up. So something like that. That is why this is the case. Or maybe like you got in the last. Okay, that also be the case. So else we can just return the start max. It was very simple for you guys. I know that this got jumbled up, but please bear with me. It will be this max and max location and max will be three, not six, six. And this was the issue. Okay. So let's just start now with another one. The last explanation. So the last explanation is very simple. This was the simplest form of exercise I can give it to you guys. It is we have four variables, some cost, some gas, and some gas and some cost will be the total amount, okay? And then we will be iterating through each one, and we will be saying that in tank we will be putting out values. So once a tank has negative integer, that means it cannot start from here. It should start from the next one so that circle can be finished. So that's what we are doing it here, if you see. Okay. And start will be equals to I plus one, as usual as that. I plus one will be the start, and we are, let's start from the next one. And as you can see, the tank will be negative till the third index. On third index, it will be positive. Okay. And so that the start will be on the third index only. Okay. So we will be only going inside this loop once the tank becomes less than zero. That means on the fourth index, on the 5-1, the tank will be greater than zero. That doesn't mean that this loop will fail. So if now the last point where we are returning is a simple if statement, is basically if sum of cost is greater than, I mean the cost is greater than the gas, it is obviously not gonna work, right? Because it's a circular path. So it will be minus one, else we can directly start. We can put the start index. And that's for you guys. I think it's the simplest explanation. I hope you like the video. And there will be many more topics in this particular, channel. It's not totally related to coding. It is like current affairs and some exams related one. And then I could put some, Blender and all those OpenShot, all those video related topics. And this is for you, channel is for you guys. Please do support us and like, comment, subscribe. Bye-bye.